Hi guys, thought I'd introduce you to my main training partner, Mel the Pell. I use this more than anything else these days for training, because I can do it, you know, during the week or whenever, when I'm not in class. You can see it's basically just a pressure-treated 4x4. It cost me 10 bucks or something like that. And I put some legs on it. I know a lot of people like to bury them in the ground, which is, it's good. That's a good way to do it. Makes it much more solid. As you can see, this knocks around. I could knock it over pretty easily if I wanted to. But on the other hand, I can take this in the house and work on it in the evening, or when there's snow on the ground, I don't feel like being outside. So it's worked out pretty good for me. I don't really like trying to smack it as hard as I can anyway. I find it really puts a lot of strain in the ligaments, and my own personal feeling is that when you get a sharp sword, you don't have to hit it that hard. So it's good for accuracy, and be able to just repeatedly throw strikes at something and instead of just the air, gives you a target to work on. So these legs here are about 3 feet across, which I would say is marginal for stability. I wouldn't go any smaller, but on the other hand, it is convenient for going in the house. A couple of supporting legs here to keep it from breaking down. What I did differently than most people, I think, is I put these little guides in here, pieces of wood, and that allows me to set up some opposition to work against. So I'm not just smacking a stick, but I'm having to actually think about getting around someone, which I find kind of useful. Plus I can position it. I have a couple of positions here, and I can set it up for different types of binds. This is probably a fairly typical bind. So not only can I strike it, but I can think about in the bind, okay, I've got something to wind against, or you know, come around, that sort of thing. So I find that really useful. I did try just a piece of flat stock here, but it was really whippy. So what I've got here is a square piece. I think it's about an inch square, 3/4 square, which makes it stiff. Put a little piece of wood in the end, so in case if I get too aggressive and smack my head into it, it doesn't hurt quite so much. But I find it really useful having this piece here. I mean, it's one thing to sit there and hit a stick over and again, but now I've got to think about, all right, how do I get in? Plus it gives me some of the play options. It just gives me things I can actually do with and get a sense of where to go. And using my imagination a bit, I can say, well, I can reposition myself. And, okay, they bound strongly. What are my options, you know? Also stuff like that. Other options, I can set it up for any position I want. Another one I've been playing with recently is a situation that results, you see this a lot with people that haven't been doing this too long, or people that just use a lot of strength, that these wind up with these high binds. See, I can now position it up high and think, okay, they're coming in high, give me a chance to work on this. Or, you know, just different positions that I can try it from. So you can put as many as you want. And I sometimes will stick it in without the guides, but you whack it around too much and they start sliding all over the place. So this is Mel. I use this all the time now, mostly in the living room. So I can spend 5 minutes playing or something, or if I want to try something. Nope, I bound. Oh, you got one high with me. I can't use that. Or I can come over, or, you know. So that's my pal, Mel the Pell.